Well, as with the human body, which is a unity, although it has many parts, all the parts of the body, though many, still making up one single body, so it is with Christ. We were baptized into one body in a single spirit, Jews as well as Greeks, slaves as well as freemen, and we were all given the same spirit to drink. And indeed the body consists not of one member, but of many. If the foot were to say, I'm not a hand, so I don't belong to the body, it doesn't belong to the body any the less for that. Or if the ear were to say, I'm not an eye, so I don't belong to the body, that would not stop its belonging to the body. If the whole body were just an eye, how would there be any hearing? If the whole body were hearing, how would there be any smelling? As it is, God has put all the separate parts into the body as he chose. And if they were all the same part, how could it be a body? As it is, the parts are many, but the body is one. The eye can't say to the hand, I've no need of you, and nor can the head say to the feet, I've no need of you. What's more, it is precisely the parts of the body that seem to be the weakest, which are the indispensable ones. It's the parts of the body that we consider least dignified, that we surround with the greatest dignity, and our less presentable parts are given greater presentability, which our presentable parts don't need. God has composed the body so that greater dignity is given to the parts which were without it, and so that there may not be disagreements inside the body, but each part may be equally concerned for all the others. If one part is hurt, all the parts share its pain. If one part is honored, all the parts share its joy. Now, Christ's body is yourselves, each of you with a part to play in the whole. And those whom God has appointed in the church are first apostles, secondly prophets, thirdly teachers, after them miraculous powers and gifts of healing, helpful acts, guidance, various kinds of tongues. Are all of them apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Are all miracle workers? Do all have the gifts of healing? Do all of them speak in tongues and all interpret them?